Once again, the United Nations Security Council sits in emergency session on the mounting crisis in the Congo. Representatives of Congo Premier Patrice Lumumba are insisting that the UN take over Katanga province by force. And the Soviet Union delivers an ultimatum for Belgian troops to get out, or else. Secretary General Hammarskjold, just returned from a trip to the troubled area, calls for a resolution that demands speedy withdrawal of Belgian troops from Katanga and assurances to the provincial premier Moise Tshomba that the United Nations will not interfere in the internal affairs of the Congo, meaning that Tshomba and Lumumba settle their differences in their own way. An internal matter or not, Katanga is very much in the international picture. President Eisenhower urges the Senate to forget politics as the legislative body reconvenes to take up such pressing matters as defense and civil rights before the campaign wars begin in earnest. However, it will be difficult to forget politics with the Republican candidate for president, Richard Nixon, presiding in the upper house. He mapped strategy with minority leaders before rapping the gavel to open the session. And outside the Senate office building, there's a big crowd waiting to see the Democratic standard bearers, John Kennedy and Majority Leader Lyndon Johnson. With all the candidates in the Senate, can politics be far behind? An ailing Fidel Castro has top billing at the closing session of the Pan-American Youth Congress in Havana. He delivers a typical rabble-rousing talk, assailing the United States and the Monroe Doctrine. After raving for a half hour, the Cuban premier loses his voice, but he regains enough strength to come back and announce his latest blow against the United States, the seizure of $750 million of American-owned properties in Cuba. Castro promises to pay for it all in 50 years, but at the rate the Cuban economy is failing, the payoff may come sooner than he expects. Of all the summer diseases man is heir to, the easiest to take is the rash of beauty contests. And the annual pageant of the International Beauty Congress at Long Beach, California, is a sight for sore eyes. The judges have 10 days of observation before they make their choice of Miss International Beauty of 1961. They say they need more time, and who can blame them?